So good afternoon students. Today in this video we will discuss about electricity and the concept of charges. Today's video content is, first we will discuss about charges, then we'll go to conservation of charges, then we will go to induction of charges, and then last numericals on the above concepts. So now if I talk about charges, as we know, atom is made up of electrons, protons and neutrons. Nucleus consists of protons and neutrons, but in this case I am ignoring neutrons and we have only protons. So now we know that electrons revolve around nucleus. So electrons carry negative charge, protons have positive charge, and we know that if we bring two opposite charges then they will attract each other, and if we bring two similar charges they will repel each other. So now we will move to conservation of charges. Conservation of charges simply say that charges can't be created nor be destroyed, only they are redistributed. Redistributed means like if see, I have body A, it contains if you touch any body and if in every day surrounding you see that you don't feel any charge on the body, it is because atom is electrically neutral. Body is electrically neutral. There is equal number of protons and equal number of electrons. Okay, so now consider body B. Now it contains 100 protons and 100 electrons, and body C that contains 100 protons and 100 electrons. Now if we bring body B and body C and we rub them each other, can also be done by any conducting material. So if we will do, then suppose that if 50 electrons I pass to it, that now what I am saying, that imagine that 50 electrons is passed to it, then it will become plus 50 electrons. So the body C will become, body C will become 100 protons and 150 electrons. So there are excess of electrons, excess of electrons, and there will be deficiency of electrons. There will be deficiency of electrons. So it, body B will become 100 protons and 50 electrons, and body C will become 100 protons and 150 electrons. This is body B, this is body C. So now you can easily see that this body has less number of electrons, body B, so it is positively charged. It has excess number of electrons, so it is negatively charged. Now see, now what the conservation of charge say, that charge can't be created nor be destroyed, it is only redistributed. So if you see this, 100 minus 50, so it becomes 50. 100 minus 150, it becomes minus 50. So obviously it is clear that it is have same number of same magnitude, same it has same magnitude it has same magnitude so this is positive, so it is positively charged. It is negative, so it is negatively charged. So it is the simple meaning of conservation of charge. So now we'll move to our induction of charges, our concept of induction of charges. So now moving to this, first before we have to understand that how we can transfer the charges. Okay, so how we can transfer the charges? Now, if I draw this simple diagram here, let me choose another color. Okay, so now let me consider this two this is a metallic sphere, so this is also some metallic sphere. This is A and this is B and this is B. So now, so if now I bring positive charge this side, मैंने क्या किया, मैंने एक पॉजिटिव चार्ज बॉडी ए के पास लेके आया. ओके, सो आई एम ब्रिंगिंग पॉजिटिव चार्ज अलोंग विद ए. ओके, नाउ व्हाट विल बी देयर, देयर विल बी ट्रांसफर ऑफ चार्जेस. हेयर इट विल बी माइनस माइनस एंड हेयर सॉरी हेयर आई एम ब्रिंग या आई एम राइट प्लस एंड हेयर इट विल बी So now here it will be minus plus 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 plus. Okay. Similarly, now consider if I bring suppose negative charge. If I bring negative charge here, if I bring negative charge here, so it will be positive, 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 and what about this? This will be negative. This will be negative. This will be negative. Okay. So we know that electric, that charge goes from positive to negative. So if I bring negative charge, obviously positive charge, it will attract positive charge. So positive charge will transfer to left hand side and negative charge will transfer to right hand side. This is the redistribution of charges and this is called induction of charges. And this is called induction of charges, that as I brought negative charge, the charges in body A and body B redistributed themselves. So electric field lines or that charge passed through positive to negative. So now if suppose in next diagram if I leave this charge, negative charge, then here in body A this will be uniformly distributed. Now the excess charge that is in the left hand side will now be uniformly distributed. So this is body A and this is body B. So this is called induction of charges, that while rubbing or any medium that helps to pass the charge between the two bodies, then how the charges redistributed themselves, it is called induction of charges. It is called induction of charges. Okay, so now we will go to numericals. So let's start numericals. So firstly, I told you about the concept of charges. Now there is something called current. So before starting the numericals, I should explain the formula I is equal to Q by T, what it means, and then we will start numericals. Okay, so now you have seen that the concept of charge. So now how you can define current? Now how can you define current? So it is like, see, we have charge, and when and what is we called electric current? Electric current is a flow of electrons flowing through wires and components. It is a rate of flow of charge. That means if I take some area, consider it some area, and how many charges are passing through it, how many chargings are passing through it in time, in time t, how many charges are passing through it, it is called in time t. Okay, so now we define, our definition of current is I is equal to q by t, the rate of flow of charge, that how many charges are flowing through a cross section of an area in time t is called current. So units, we know that charge is made in coulomb, time is made in your seconds, and I is made in, current is made in ampere. So rate of flow of charge is current, so it is made in ampere. Okay, so now we will start the numericals. I directly start with unsolved numericals. You will get more concept of this, how to use this. So let's start with first numerical. Okay, so starting with first numerical, our first numerical says that 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 8 coulomb charges flows through a conductor in 10 raised to power 10 seconds. 10 raised to minus 10 seconds, find the current flowing through the conductor. So we have to calculate the current. So what we have given? We have given the charges. We have given the charge Q and we have given our time. Okay. So what we will do now, current I is equal to Q by T. Okay. Put the value of Q, 1.6 into 10 raised to power minus 8, and this 10 raised to power minus 10. So we know that 1.6 into 10 raised to power minus 8 into 10 raised to power 10, it will become 1.6 into 10 raised to power, this will become 2. So I think this is 8 or minus 8. Yeah, 8. So it will become 1.6 into 10 raised to power 2 ampere. I think they are, if this is 8, then they are using, I think, yeah, this is right. So now, second, a current of 2 ampere flows through a conductor for 3.0 seconds. What amount of charge passed through a conductor? So we are given the current, value of current, value of time is also given. We have to find the amount of charge. So we know that Q is equal to I into T. I is 2 into 3.0, so it will become 6 coulomb. Now third sum, a conductor carries a current of 20 ampere, find the amount of the charge that will pass through the conductor in half minute. In half minute, so time is given as half and the current is given as 20. So half minute is given, we have to convert into seconds. This is minute, so we have to convert into seconds. So now it will become 30 seconds. Half minute means 30 seconds. Then Q is equal to I into T is 600 coulomb. So we have done our first numerical, second, third we have done. Now we will shift to our fourth numerical. Now we will shift to our fourth numerical. So what, you will solve fourth numerical? 50,000 coulomb of charge flows through a conductor if current is measured 500 ampere, for how long did the charge flow? We have to calculate the time. So we have to calculate the time. So time means T is equal to Q upon I. Okay. So 50,000 divided by 500. Okay. So it will become 100 second. It will become 100 second. Now we have also done fourth. So now fifth question, 500 coulomb of charge flows through conductor on 10 second, calculate the current. So current will is given as Q upon T. So we know Q is 500 and it conductor on a 10 second. 10 second, so it will become 50 ampere. They are very simple numericals. Only the thing is you have to remember the formula I is equal to Q upon T. You have given two quantities and you have to calculate the other. Only this much in this exercise. So we have done fourth sum also, fifth sum also. Okay. So now our sixth sum. So in sixth sum, what it says, for how many hours should 10 ampere current flow through a conductor to ensure a passage of 72,000 coulombs of charge? So we have given your I is equal to, so we have given I is equal to 10 ampere and we have given Q is equal to 72,000. Okay, so you have to calculate the time. So first, we know that if, so calculating the time, T is equal to Q upon I, so it will become 72,000 divided by your 10. So it will become 7200 and this is in your seconds. This is in second, so you have to convert it into hours. So how you will convert it into hours? You will divide by 60 into 60. So it will become your 2 hours. 2 hours. So we have done our sixth numerical also. Okay. So now we will proceed to our seventh numerical. So okay, now in this numerical what it is, you can read the sum by pausing the video. So in this sum it is asking seventh sum, if a current of 5 milliamperes flow through a conductor for 10 seconds, calculate the charge flow. So obviously the formula you will put is I is equal to Q by T, and you have given you have to calculate the charges flow. You have to calculate the charges flow. So let's calculate. Seventh sum, I is equal to 5 milliampere. So you can change it into ampere. 5 into 10 raised to the minus 3 ampere. You have to divide it by 1000 to change it into ampere. Then time is equal to 10 second. So Q is equal to I into T. So you will do this, then you will get 5 into 10 raised to the minus 2, which means 0.05 coulomb. Okay, so I have done also 7th sum. So now I will do 8th sum. Okay, so now two conductors A and B carry current 3 ampere and 7 ampere respectively. Calculate the charge flowing through them in 35 minutes. Second, if the charge of the conductor A were to flow in conductor B, how much time it will take? So there are two questions. So first, two conductors A and B carry current 3 ampere and 7 ampere. Okay. So in first, it is asking the charge flow through them in 35 minutes. Time is also given. Time is 35 minutes. So answer 35 minutes. Okay. So it, I will convert into second. So it will become 35 into 60. Okay. So 35 into 60. So I'll do it later when I'll solve it. So 35 into 60. Now, it is basically done to ease the calculation. Okay, so now Q is equal to I into T. I is 3. Okay, I is 3 into 35 into 60, which means it is 6300 coulomb. Okay, now similarly in Q is equal to IB into T is equal to 7 into 35 into 60, which means 14700 coulomb. Okay, so now we have calculated our first. Now second, if the charge of the conductor A were to flow in conductor B, how much time it will take? Now in second, it is asking the time. So time is given by Q is equal to I. So 6300 upon 7. So it will become 900 second. Okay. So if I'll convert into minutes, it is because the answer is in minutes. So I'll divide by 60. So it will become 15 minutes. Okay. So it is becoming 15 minutes. So I have solved 8th sum also. So I've done all the numericals. I have only left with 9. So it is homework for you. It is very easy. Now I've done all the 8 numericals. So you can try for 9th. And also examples are also very easy. Okay. So this video is up to here only. So I hope you enjoyed the video. And if you have any queries, you can comment. And I will surely answer them. So thank you very much.